Today's Illustrator tutorial is going to teach you how to make a neat vector planet, so stay tuned. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today, you're going to learn how to make a vector planet by following my step-by-step tutorial. Today, we're working on a web-based graphic, and so we're going to need to choose an RGB color mode, and that is red, green, and blue, which is the color mode for any kind of graphic that you see on screen. Try making a fairly large canvas and keep the PPI to 72, which again is perfect for web-based graphics. Once your document is ready, we can begin the tutorial. We're going to start by making the shape of the light to shadow part of the vector planet, as you can see in the top right of the screen. So grab the rounded rectangle tool, and then you can either click on screen to type in precise measurements, or you can just drag and generate a shape like so. If you have Adobe Illustrator CC, just press A for the direct selection tool and simply round off the corners using the live corners. But if you don't have CC, just come up to the round corners effect in the top drop down menu. Once you've rounded off the corners like so, hold down the Alt Option key and then click and drag to duplicate the shape. Now press M to access the rectangle tool, and you will notice purple lines on my screen here. Those are actually smart guides, and we need them activated, but if you don't see them, just press Command or Control U. So still using the rectangle tool, click and draw a rectangle exactly the same size as the original shape. Now stretch the rectangle out like so, and then make sure they are perfectly aligned, and you can do this by using the vertically alignment function right at the top here. We're now going to use the Pathfinder function to cut one shape into another, and you can locate the Pathfinder window right here. You do need to make sure that the rounded rectangle is brought to the front of all other objects, and then perform the minus front option in the Pathfinder window. So we're nearly finished on this part of the tutorial, and you just now need to place the shape perfectly below the first one like so, and then make a duplicate below. Select all shapes and duplicate them perfectly, and then press Command or Control D to repeat the process. Finally, unite all of these shapes together in the Pathfinder window, so there is now just one vector shape. We can now go ahead and create our vector planet, and it is really quite simple, but it does look really awesome and neat. First, let's make a dark background to represent space. I'm going to use a dark blue for mine, but feel free to experiment with your design. Lock the background down after you've made it, and then choose a color for your planet, and then press L for the ellipse tool. Hold down the Shift key, and then click and drag to make a perfect circle, which is going to be the base of our vector planet today. And speaking of base, we need to go and open the layers window, and rename this layer to something like base, because it is the base layer of the design. You can do that by double-clicking the layer. With the base layer selected, press Command or Control C to copy it, and then press Command or Control F to paste a duplicate right over the top. In the layers window, you can see the duplicate, but go ahead and rename it to Highlight. This is just going to help us keep things organized today. Now click the shape that we made earlier, and make sure it's the front of all layers by going up to Object and Bring to Front, and then hold down Shift and click the shape and also the highlight layer together. Again, use the minus front option in the Pathfinder panel, and then adjust its color to make it seem like a highlight on your vector planet. Now we just have to add some awesome effects that are really going to make our design stand out. In the layers window, navigate to the base layer and hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag to duplicate it below. Now go ahead and change the layer name to Ring 1. Select it, hold down Shift and the Alt Option key at the same time, and then you can resize it like so. On the Ring 1 layer, we're going to add a radial gradient, and the colors that you use are totally up to you, but I'm going to make mine in hues of purple for my vector planet. So when you've established your gradient, go ahead and lower the opacity of the object via the top drop-down menu. Then, duplicate Ring 1 layer as we did before, and rename it to Ring 2. By using the Alt Option key and Shift, resize it larger than the previous one. The opacity is actually the same as the first one, so there's no need to adjust it. And finally, duplicate Ring 2 and add a third ring and rename it. We're almost finished today, and you can adjust the size of your planet like so, but I prefer to keep mine at this scale. Now go ahead and select Ring 3 in the Layers window and access the Effects menu. We're going to want to add a Gaussian blur, and you should keep the preview box checked to play around with the values until you're happy with the blur. If your raster effects look pretty poor like mine do, come into the Document Raster Effects settings and increase the values here. You can then use all of these techniques to make your own planets and your own designs in Adobe Illustrator. If you want to increase your skills and your awareness as a designer, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Also, remember to like and share my content on social media, because it really does help out my channel. And of course, make sure to have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.